Let's talk about your three senior guys who have been in the program for the last 4 years that you were able to identify early in the recruiting process. This is kind of your first go-through with these three guys. So what have they meant to your program? So I'm talking about, obviously, Brandon, Rudy, and Luis.
Yeah, it's you know, the recruiting process for us, number one, we try to identify guys that we think are high character guys, and then we want to try to identify guys that we know love the game and are competitive and want to get better and are committed to getting better, and that are going to be better 2-3 years down the road maybe than they are now, and those three guys all fit that bill. You know, I think any coach can go out and say that this guy's a really good player, but what you've got to evaluate, how are these guys going to fit together with the team we have right now? How are they going to fit together down the road 2 or 3 years? And I take a lot of pride in our ability as a coaching staff to do that. And then with Luis and Rudy and BG, as example now in the fourth year here, you know, those guys have gotten so much better as players. And I think between the strength coach that we have here, between the availability of three gyms to work out in, between player development with our coaching staff, you know, I'd put our ability to develop those guys up there with anybody. And those guys are a perfect example of three guys maybe that weren't the most highly recruited guys, and now they're a cornerstone on a 17-3 team and leaders on and off the floor, a great point guard, a great wing defender, and a potential All-American up front that is going to be a third-time All-Conference guy. So those guys mean a lot to our program for sure, and they've been a joy to coach and a joy to see them get better, and their commitment to winning and their commitment to improvement and their commitment to our entire program just growing as young men, I'd put it up against anybody. Those three have been phenomenal, and we've really been able to build our program around them. You know, now the challenge is after this year to go out and find three or four more guys to keep building that up after that, because those guys have meant a lot to us, and I just appreciate all the work that they've put in because they've had great careers here.
Spoke of developing those guys at risk of injecting rat poison in this conference. You have a player that's 30 points away from being your all-time leading scorer. How special is that that he could have that on the dome this weekend?
Yeah, you know, Tyler's career has been special. You know, he came in, played limited minutes the first half of his freshman year, and it just didn't faze him. You know, he was getting beat up in practice. He had older guys, Division I transfer that was playing in front of him at that time. And he just kept coming and fighting every day. And every day he thought he was the best player on the floor, but he also understood that he needed coaching. And he took coaching really well, continued to develop, continued to play hard every day. And next thing you know, at the second half of the season, he starts playing a little bit more than our starter. And then his last 3 years have been, you know, he'll be all conference. It will be really historic. He'll end up being the all-time leading scorer and rebounder probably. Already the all-time leading rebounder, as you mentioned, 30 points away from the all-time leading scorer here at Minot State. A guy that, you know, his work ethic is off the charts. What he does, his conditioning level, the extra time he puts in, he's really turned himself into a guy, maybe made 8 threes his freshman year, to a guy that's shooting over 50% from three right now, and we put in situations to get him inside and outside. So he's had a special career. And again, I've told a lot of people this story, and I probably said it sitting up here before. The best thing about him is after his junior year when we had our meeting and we asked what his goals are, he said, win more games, and walked out of the office and looked upset that I would ask if he had any individual goals. He just wants to win everything, whether that's a shooting contest that's going on in the court right now when I walk by, or whether that's a practice scrimmage or a rebounding drill or a game on a Friday or Saturday night. He competes extremely hard all the time. You have guys that are relentless like that in the level that they compete at, and you got a chance to win a lot of basketball games. And he's raised the level of everybody in our program for the last 3 or 4 years now, so he's a special one. And, you know, he's going to be embarrassed as heck when he does that and people start asking him about it, because he doesn't want to be the center of attention. He just wants to walk off the court with a victory on Friday and hopefully try to do it again on Saturday.
Did those kind of qualities for Rudy to have, did that kind of show you early on whether when you were recruiting him or when he was taking those bumps in his freshman year that he could be capable of being the all-time scorer and rebounder here?
Yeah, you know, early on you just ask, you call a high school coach and I ask him, how much does this kid love the game? And it's interesting to see because a lot of guys will say this guy's a hard worker, or he likes it a lot, and then I'll ask, what does that look like? And for Tyler, that looked like being in the gym 2-3 hours a day outside of practice. And then I ask, next thing I ask after how much he loves the game is how competitive is he? And coming from Bismarck Century, Coach Mattern said he's as competitive as they come in that regard too. And we knew we had a chance because, I mean, quite frankly, he wasn't good enough to play here at that time. And, so you got to look a few years down the road. But when you're that competitive and you want to and you love the game that much, you're going to get a lot better. And it's all about improvement at the college level. How much better can you get from day one to your fourth year? And he's got just a world better. And you know, he's a guy that he could do pretty much anything right now, and it wouldn't surprise me because he just competes all day long.
Two opponents this weekend, pretty good at home and really bad on the road, and this is the longest road trip for them that they're going to have. Is that maybe something you would hope to use to your advantage?
Well, you've got to win at home. You got to find a way to win basketball games at home, and we've been pretty good in the dome the last 3-4 years. I think we've got a great record here. We've played well. I think everybody's a little bit better maybe at home than they are on the road. But, you know, regardless of where we lace them up, I think we've got 8 games left, and we're going to have to really compete. We've got to play with an edge. We've got to have a defensive mindset. We've got to be a team that wins loose balls and talks and communicates because we don't have great individual defenders. And when we've done that, we've been pretty good. We go out there and play a little bit angry on the defensive side of the court. We've got a chance to win, and we've done that 17 times, and we've got a few times where we didn't do that. And lost, so we've got to make sure we're home, road, whatever. You know, that defensive intensity, that toughness, that desire to win loose balls and the 50-50 balls, that desire to do all the little things, that stuff wins no matter where you're at. So the team that does that better is going to have a great chance. And I think we play two teams that are extremely scrappy and do a lot of the little things to win. So we've got to make sure we compete at a high level, that's for sure.
Coach, you feel like you know, last week, I know you said you were like, a little worried about that trip, and you know, you got the split. But coming home, teams like this, Maya State, you know, has that kind of obviously bullseye on the back, now target on the back, being 17-3. Do you feel teams pick their game up and come at you a little different, and you have to play even tougher at home and when you can?
Yeah, you know, I think it's such a good league that most teams are going to bring it every night. But you know, I know that it's pretty easy. As a college athlete, and I remember when I played, if you play a team that's towards the top of the rankings, you're a little bit more excited probably. And I don't know how long that lasts in the game. I don't know how much that adrenaline goes, but I think you're a little more excited to play those teams near the top if they're ranked, if they're near the top of the league standings. And you know, we're playing two teams that have a lot of pride and have a pretty successful program the last you know, decade or however long it's been, and they're teams that are used to winning. So I know they're going to compete. I know they're going to feel like they should come in here and win. And it's up to us to really, as any game, just to out-compete them. You know, us being 17-3 and them being whatever they are, it doesn't matter come Friday night. You know, we'll tip it off for 40 minutes, and whoever plays like they have more to prove has got a good chance to win.